between all of you and his lordships. May I now invite his lordships to share his experiences?
Thank you, Mr. Jain. A very good morning to all present. As we say, good morning, namaskar, adab, sat sri akal, because it's a national conference, not limited to area. And since morning, you see, there had been number of speakers. Everybody had taken the names of all the guests and also the organizers. So I will not repeat that. I will simply say, because we are on virtual mode, and in the virtual mode, we use IT, computer, language. So I will simply say cut, copy, and paste. So as is used in the computer language, we say. And now you see, we all have with us Justice Brother Ujjal Bhavan, Sister Anita Sumanth, Brother Kalyan Surana, Brother Piyush Agarwal, and Brother Sumitra Sekia. Now it is, and me from Jammu and Kashmir. Now it's like news. They say north, east, west, and south. We are from the throughout the country, and the conference is being organized or managed at Prayagraj, almost the center. So the organizers certainly need to be congratulated for that. Brother Surana had referred to that what a speaker or a guest in a conference should do. His idea was that he should be brief in speaking, otherwise his depth of knowledge comes out. Yes, he is right. We should not speak much, because we have a lot of learned speakers in the technical sessions to share their views. And in one of the conferences, I will share that Mr. P.P. Rao, senior advocate, we are certainly a constitutional expert, he said a chief guest or a speaker in a function, especially on an inaugural function, what are his jobs? He should say he should see the comfortable seat. He should smile a little bit in between. He should speak less and leave quietly. So leaving quietly, speaking less, yes. Leaving quietly is easy here, because anybody can just say the work connection and all that, so just we can switch off. There is connectivity problem. So we are on virtual mode, so that is very easy now. Now coming to the day, yes, many speakers have already said this is a historic day, 2nd October. We all know, had we been in Prayagraj, this would have been a long weekend, we would have all enjoyed. And seeing the number of registration, maybe we could have called it a mini Kumbh also, especially in Prayagraj, more than 3,500 registration. We know today is the birthdays of our Rashtrapita Mahatma Gandhi and our ex-Prime Minister Lal Bahadur Shastri. And what Gandhi said, there are many quotes of Gandhi. One has been referred to by Sister Anita also. Another is that be the change you want to see in the world. So we have to start from ourselves. As was only suggested by Brother Bhavan also, IT. Yes, I'll touch that also. But we have to start ourselves, not wait that somebody else will do something and then things will move. No, we have to start from ourselves. As we say, charity begins at home. So one has to start. So that lead we have to take as a federation. And then our late Lal Bahadur Shastri, what he said, he had given us a slogan, Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan. We all know it. And we are seeing now the agriculture community, maybe rightly, wrongly, I'm not commenting on that. They are up in arms because of certain changes made by the parliament and army also. We are knowing we are facing a very difficult situation, because I know little better because I am close to that area. And this fact is there that this virtual meeting is certainly a different kind of experience. In this, we have a lot of options. The lawyers also have a lot of options. I am reminded of a very old joke I'll share with you, that that's the time when there used to be landline phone connections. So one son was having a conversation with his father. The telephone the intercity calls used to be through booking. 180 probably was the number. You had to book and then maybe half an hour, 1 hour, you will be connected. So he was studying in some different city. He was asking his father that you send me some money. So money, my all finances are over. So father was saying, yes, yes, hello, hello. I'm not hearing. So operator was just fed up in between. He said, why you are not hearing? Everything is clear and he is just asking for money only because he has finished all his money. The answer of the father was that if you are hearing, then you send the money to him. So this is what sometimes is happening in court also. A lawyer who is connected with you in one case, maybe uncomfortable case, will say, no, I'm not hearing anything. There is some problem in audio or video. But in the other case, maybe after 10 minutes, maybe DB or single bench. So these kind of experiences also we are having in court now. Now coming to the title of the theme. Yes, it is very important. They have chosen the title as Gyan Pravaha 2020. Now, if we see the virtual meaning, Gyan means knowledge and Pravaha means flow. This is a pandemic year. Yes. We have all faced is still facing. Nobody knows when this will end. World over, everybody is affected. Now, as we normally see, pravaha, flow of a river or water is from upside down. But this is a kind of flow where the sea level has no meaning or the level of the place has no meaning. We are sitting at Prayagraj. And the knowledge is flowing throughout the country. And this is a flow of knowledge from the experts or experienced persons in the field, which has no barriers, no obstacles in between. And this year, as the pandemic is there, a lot of you see the jokes or messages are being circulated. Living is more important because what we are seeing, and one of the messages said, somebody said, is July now. Congratulations, you have crossed level 6, you are on level 7. So we are in level 10 now, 12 levels in this year. So we have to take care. And this fact is not unknown to all that how this pandemic has changed our lives. Lives changing is not only the professional life. Our personal life has also changed. Our priorities have changed. Our way of being made because of this pandemic. Our younger generation now feel that your fast food is not the only thing. There are many options at home also because during the initial period, everybody was at home and they have explored, the younger generation also explored many things and learned. This had given a positive part of it, that this has given a time or opportunity to the families to live together. Otherwise, everybody was busy in their own work. So as sister had touched the issue, that we should take opportunity in this problem time. Now in this, we are seeing more than 3,000 members and the experts will share their knowledge. And as a last speaker, it's very difficult because most of the content is already shared. And as far as tax is concerned, I was elevated in 2006, yes, but I think initially for 1.5 years I was on the tax bench. And thereafter, most of the time I'm doing civil and criminal work. In Jammu Kashmir, if you say, there are very few tax cases because a lot industry or your business is not that much as is there in the other states. In Punjab we had, and Bombay is a yes, commercial capital, a lot of commercial issues or taxation issues. So in that, as we sit in the court, we have been 6 speakers in this inaugural function. And as we do in the court, as a last person, suppose some judgment is reserved and the judgment from other brother and sister comes, the last man only says simply, I agree. So I will not venture into anything. So I will simply put my thumb mark on that. I agree. So that will save me from touching anything. Now you see, coming to the profession, yes, little bit I will also share some experiences. I was just hearing the recorded version of Prime Minister's lecture on 13/8/2020 he had given. This was on tax reforms, transparent taxation, and honoring the honest. Maybe somebody has thought of honoring the honest also, otherwise the honest taxpayer was sometimes taken to be a evader only. So he referred to three issues: faceless assessment, faceless appeal, and taxpayer's charter. Good, maybe this was already in the agenda of the government, but it had come in the time of COVID-19. Yes, now faceless assessment, they say there would be regional electronic assessment centers. So as a result of which, all the assessments in the country, because what figures he had given, that the assessment is now, scrutiny is probably in 0.28% cases. Earlier it was 0.7 or something cases. So very few cases are taken up in scrutiny. So what this idea is, that the assessment of any SSC can go from place A to place B. And that means from north to south and east to west. No personal interaction. Now in this case, the problem, I don't know, this is a new thing coming up. How, as we are seeing in the court also, sometimes we are facing difficulty in hearing complicated cases through VC. How the opportunity of hearing will be affected, how it will be given, how all these facts will be appreciated. Like what I foresee, I don't know, future will tell what solutions we have. There are problems relating to maybe the taxation relating to mining. And suppose the case is transferred to a place where nobody knows about what is mining, what are the intricacies thereof, or some orchard in Jammu and Kashmir, and the case is transferred to a place, maybe in Odisha, no orchards. We have cases regarding coastal areas, regarding fishing. Nobody knows how this will go, how the people work, what kind of expenses are made. Like one of the persons shared with me that we have spinning mills, and in the spinning mills, this is a system that you give the jaggery to the employees, because a lot of dust is there so that it can settle down. And if the assessee claims expense on that account, some ITO sitting at a far off place who may not have idea of that kind of industry may disallow that expense. So that kind of problems will come. And the other problem which I foresee, maybe the language of documents in different areas, there may be connectivity problems also. And there may be issues regarding IT related uploading of large number of documents, because we have problems at some places. And another thing is that sometimes inquiries are also made locally. So how all these facts will be taken care of? But still, we need a very robust website for that, the system IT platform of the department. We all know that when GST was introduced, though the government had engaged a private company for that, initial times it also crashed because of the load. So that also the government has to take care of. But it is a challenge in the profession, in the way that competence will be the top. Because now, as has already been shared, there is no barrier. We have seen Mr. Salve appearing from London. He is living in London now, England, and appearing in the cases in Delhi and other states also, other high courts also. So that barrier is not there. Anybody can engage a counsel from anywhere, any chartered accountant, for conducting a case. Faceless, maybe the government thought of that, yes, it may be good, maybe some corruption is taken care of, but it may have its own problems which may be sorted out with the passage of time. And another important aspect in this case, as has already been touched, is the training of the professionals. They have to train themselves in IT. Otherwise, we will all lag behind. They may have to depend on some staff, some support, which may not be good in a long term, because everybody has to depend, to be independent in this. And this problem with this pandemic, in fact, we had faced in the courts also, because a lot of our lawyers or their clerks are not trained in this IT part. So the e-committee of the Supreme Court, which guides all the high courts on e-platform, We have opened, the E-Committee has directed opening of E-Seva Kendras in all the high courts, which will help the litigants, the lawyers or their clerks to file the cases, soft copy of the paperwork, scanning and all that. So that kind of a facility may have to be created by the Income Tax Department if it has to go IT, and to give the places also like kiosks to upload the documents also, because connectivity and the speed, especially as we say in Jammu and Kashmir, we have 2G only. At some places it is 4G, though broadband is there, but people have some difficulties. Now, another thing which professionals may have opportunity or may not have, because a lot of defaults are there. So companies, a lot of companies are restructuring. So in that also the role of tax professionals is certainly very important. And as is shared by Sister Anita, yes, we need to have some norms, because this is a new thing which has come. And all of a sudden, maybe we were not ready to take it as the only solution. Though off and on we had been doing in Jammu Kashmir also, we had been using the IT platform for VC, because there had been hearing of cases from Jammu to Srinagar, Srinagar to Jammu, the lawyer at different places, and even the benches also, one judge at Jammu and one at Srinagar, and the lawyer also maybe at two different places. So we have been doing it, but it was not that 100% we were doing it as now we are doing, because a lot of cases are there in Kashmir and Jammu. So sometimes we had to close the court also, and it was total virtual. Now also we are doing total virtual, only the soft copies of the paper book and hearing through VC. There is no court hearing. So this we have to see. And the advocates conduct also, yes, Supreme Court has also commented upon. There was a video being circulated. A senior counsel in the Supreme Court was smoking also. He was having hookah. And there are other car also. Some people are appearing in t-shirts also. So that kind of a thing, yes, we have to maintain some decorum in the profession. And that message, I think we can give from this platform and to the lawyers to start with that. No, if this system is to remain in place, I think we should maintain it, not like doing, because what difficulty we are seeing there, that number of lawyers, they have just opened 3-4 laptops. They are attending the hearing, sitting in their office, 3-4 courts simultaneously. And the mic of all the courts is on. So cross arguments also we are hearing. So that is disturbing. In a lot of counsels, they don't wait. They just start speaking. One is arguing the case. He will also just all of a sudden interject and say, my case is this one. Because you see, practically, we are not able to maintain the cause list in the way that serial number wise cases are taken up. Because those practical difficulties are there, whosoever counsel joins. So we take up his case and maybe he has 3-4 cases. So we finish off all these 3-4 cases, maybe a different serial number. This is what we are following there, because we can't allow them to wait, because they all remain in the waiting area or continue joining on the VC. So, but still we have to have some norms, some discipline is required for that. And another thing which the professionals have to take care of, because we all know that in this time there has been very less revenue generation to the government and the spending is more. So maybe, I don't know, I have no idea as such, but maybe as seeing that there may be some effort by the government to generate revenues. So there are two parts of it. One is that we should not be party to evasion of tax. I always say that we should be honest in that, because any burden of an honest taxpayer, burden of a dishonest taxpayer, a tax evader always falls on the honest taxpayer, because the government has to have his revenues, whatever is required. And secondly, the compliances, especially the technical compliances, which are picked by the computers, because artificial intelligence is used now to pick up the cases. So wherever there are technical violations, non-compliances, the computer may pick up those cases. So we have to ensure that we don't give that opportunity. There is no intention to evade tax. There is no evasion of tax, or maybe some fault here and there. So that I think we need to take care. And regarding revenue, yes, pending I have touched, yes. Now, as far as the backlog of cases is concerned, yes, this period is really difficult. We will face this difficulty, I think, in the year to come also, because of the backlog being forwarded in the carry forward, like the counts we say. But what we are trying in Jammu and Kashmir is that we are listing all the old matters also, very, very old matters. And we have been able to take up those matters. Maybe some are covered by any judgment, not taken care of by the lawyers also, court also, because the present cause list is very long. And sometimes the lawyers or the professionals can also help judgment of the court with the passage of time, or may have been rendered infructuous with the passage of time. If that help is given by the professionals, maybe we are able to use this time positively. And not that all the cases we carry forward, because if all the cases are carried forward, yes, we will face difficulty in next year also, just to streamline the working. And there may not be effective working in court. There was another thing regarding the technical part, but I can just share you because there are a lot of anecdotes in the Yes, am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are.
Okay. So there was some disconnection in between.
Yes.
So on the technical part, lot of, you see, anecdotes are there in the court. I will just share that. One of the lawyers, he just argued a case and came out of the court. So his client, he was semi-literate, he could not understand everything. So he said, Vakil Saab, what was the law point argued by you? I could not understand. His answer was that law point, I don't tell even the judge. He can ask me 10 times. You are saying I should tell you this law point. So that kind of a thing, these legal issues, because these may come to the court. We can't comment on that. But yes, for discussion point of view, these are very important issues. And in this pandemic, there are a lot of amendments being made in the law, and we need to be updated and guide and advise our clients accordingly so that there are no defaults as such. So I think I will not take much time. Time was only up to 10:45. Mr. Sanjay had strongly directed. So I will only end by saying that I am thankful to the organizers for giving me this opportunity to meet all the friends. It would have been good had it been at Prayagraj. We would have come, shared our views, and enjoyed the hospitality also. Now we are enjoying the virtual hospitality, but I wish the conference a great success. Thank you very much.